Alright guys, so I'm gonna bring you into my house and show you a couple things about what I do in my kitchen. Now, you will notice I am holding a selfie stick. That's right, I actually bought a selfie stick for this purpose of doing some vlog type stuff. Anyway, I'm gonna take you in my kitchen here in my house and I'm gonna show you how I do my meal prep. Now, meal prep is a pain in the butt and it is so helpful. I'm gonna tell you why, because having to wake up and prep your meals every single day is it's just dumb. It just takes up so much time. So if you can get all your meals prepped for the entire week in just an hour and a half's time, dude, it's gonna save you so much time. So we're gonna come into my kitchen. I'm gonna show you some of the things I do, how I meal prep exactly to the T, all right? Dude, if you meal prep, you have got to buy these things. Look, they come with a fork and a knife. Walmart, bro, it's like $5 and you get packs of three. You can see right here, I've got 10. That's basically my lunch and my dinner for the next 5 days. You're probably wondering, what do you do with your other meals? Well, I'm a very busy man, and I drink a lot of protein shakes, and I eat some other stuff. But my main meals that I prep for are lunch and dinner, and that's when I really need the most. So check this out, man. You got a lid, you got three compartments. Typically what I do is I put all my rice here, I put my veggies here, and I eat beef, ground beef. Now, I was eating chicken, nothing but chicken, for years and years and years. Check this out. If you eat chicken all the time, man, you're gonna get a food allergy, straight up. Your body's not gonna assimilate it right. And guess what? I just got freaking sick of chicken. I eat beef, bro. I eat beef all the dang time. Now, check it out. I'm gonna bring you with me. Go to Walmart, get Yin's one of these, all right? Now, you're gonna notice it's 80% lean, 20% fat. This is gonna run me about $19, which is not bad. If you were to go out to eat, okay, every single lunch and dinner, you're gonna spend way more than $20 a week. Now, I'm not too worried about the fat content, because what I usually do, I wanna grab a strainer. I literally cook this stuff so much, it separates from the fat. Then I put all the cooked ground beef in a strainer and I rinse it off and get like all the fat off. You will know that if you cook ground beef, you cook a steak, if you cook it on a grill or you cook it on a stove or whatever the situation is, dude, a lot of that fat just comes off. Monday through Friday, look at me, man. Monday through Friday, I eat like a squirrel, bro. I like literally barely eat Monday through Friday, but Friday night hits, I get froyo post-workout. Saturday, I eat some cheat meals. Sunday, I eat some cheat meals. And then Monday, it's right back to it, bro. Strict dieting and cardio. So check it out. I also got my favorite kind of rice. This is gonna run you about $20 at Walmart, okay? Jasmine rice is the best. Let me explain why. First off, white rice, when you make white rice, it tastes like crap when you microwave it. It does. When you first cook it, it tastes so good, but you microwave it, it gets dry and just doesn't hold that moisture. Same thing, brown rice is worse, man. You reheat brown rice in a microwave, it's gonna taste like crap. So, jasmine rice, I feel that when you cook it, you prep it and you microwave it, it still retains a lot of stickiness, a lot of moisture, and actually tastes so dang good after you microwave it. So check it out, 20 pound bags are gonna run you around $20. It's gonna last you so dang long, it's gonna be so well worth it. All right, check it out, what do I got next? Bro, look, dude, these veggies are cheap, son. Cheap as heck. This is gonna run you around like probably $6, $5. I'm being told it's $5, okay? Dude, look, you got the cauliflower, you got the broccoli, you got the currants, right? Currants, boy. Dude, so low carb. And of course, you have got to have seasoning. Now, what I do is I put the chicken seasoning on the beef. It sounds so stupid, but it is so good. Put this on the beef while you're cooking it. I put the Mrs. Dash right here. Look at these. Mrs. Dash right here on the veggies. Oh my gosh, bro. Like, I get so hungry during the day that by the time it's lunchtime, I'm like so super excited for my meal. Also, what you're gonna need, my man, all right? This is for all y'all people that don't meal prep, man. Paula Deen, my girlfriend's telling me Paula Deen, okay? Paula Deen, bro, at Big Lots. Ain't no shame in shopping at Big Lots, bro, okay? This is like $4. No, I'm kidding, dude.
Came in like a set. It was like $20.
It was like $20. It's actually pretty nice. But get you a big pot. We're gonna have several pots out here. One big pot for rice, another pot for the veggies, and a big old pan for the meat, dude. You're gonna have about, and you're gonna see, you're gonna have like three different things going on at the same time. What you wanna do with meal prep, bro, get you a beer or something, whatever your favorite drink is. Get a protein shake, put some dang music on. I prefer reggae. I like Solomon Jabby's, one of my favorite reggae artists. Bro, just knock this thing out, man. Don't sit here and fickle around, be stupid with it, and just make it a day-long process. This should take you 1 hour of your time. It's gonna get you 10 meals throughout the day, all right?
So here you can see we got the meat going by my lovely girlfriend. Look, do yourself a favor, find you a girlfriend that'll meal prep for you, like my lovely girlfriend cooking up this meat right here, right? What you wanna do with this meat, man? You wanna just keep chopping it up, put that seasoning on there, get it mixed up. First and foremost, you wanna preheat that pan, put some oil in there. You can put cooking spray in there. If you wanna go the cheaper route, you can just put like a big bottle of oil and just pour a little bit in there. We got the veggies. Same kind of concept with the veggies, man. You wanna put a little bit of oil in there, preheat that pan. Once that starts cooking, mix it up, get that seasoning going. And then of course here, we got the water getting ready to boil for the jasmine rice. So we got the whole setup here. Couple things you wanna make sure you got. First off, you wanna make sure you got a measuring cup. You're wasting your time meal prepping if you're not measuring your stuff out, okay? You gotta have the food scale. Make sure you're getting enough protein and carbs in that. Measuring cups are solid food. You gotta have a measuring cup for liquids. All right, now we're at the point where we're finalizing everything. Cooking time, probably like half an hour so far.
Check it out, man. Got that beef going, big dog. Look at all them gains, man, in one pot. Dude, jasmine rice is a freaking bomb, man. I don't give a crap. Look how good that is, dude. It's so nice and fluffy. Perfect, man. Got my veggies all hooked up, dog. Heck yeah, get all things going on at the same time. All right, check it out. Put the meat in there. Rinse it off. You're rinsing all that fat off, man. Oh, man. She spilled a crumb in the sink, dog. That was like a couple grams of protein. Man, you grab that and wash that off, man. That's good meat. Don't put it back in there, man. Bro, you want to know a game changer? This crap right here. Oh my gosh. Walden Farms original calorie-free barbecue sauce is money. It's a game changer. Dude, this stuff tastes so good. And when you're dieting, oh my gosh. It's the bomb, man. So good. Adds so much flavor to everything. No calories. You don't got to worry about like regular barbecue sauce, which has like, you know, 160 calories per 2 tablespoons. Go to your local store. Get this stuff right here. All right, so now we're adding the veggies. Look, put that Walden's Farm barbecue sauce on the meat. Got the veggies. Boom, yeah. Now, what you're looking at here is roughly around 8 ounces of ground beef, about a cup of rice, and obviously a little less than that with the veggies. So I'm actually trying to cut up, so we are not using a ton of carbs. So again, about 8 ounces of ground beef, cup of rice, half cup veggies. Now the veggies, I don't really measure too strictly. We're just kind of throwing them in there. We know how much we threw in there initially, and we're just kind of dividing it up amongst 10 different meals. There you go, man. All 10 sitting in the fridge. Wake up in the morning before work, run in there, grab one, slap it in my lunchbox with the ice packs, and I am good to go. Well, there you have it, guys. Thanks for coming into my kitchen. Hopefully you learned some good stuff about meal prepping, some of the things I do at my crib in reference to getting my meals in. Hopefully it's been educational for you, man. Hey, don't forget to subscribe. Look forward to some more vlogs I'm gonna be doing, and we'll see you then.